Hi friends, this is Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to see about the thread lifecycle in a detailed manner. We will try to compare with the real-time scenario for getting these content in a clear manner. So first, that five stages: new, runnable, running, terminated, and non-runnable. So this is the initial stage where the threads are getting created. You suppose if you create n number of threads, then n number of threads will be created in this stage only. So all those threads are eligible for running. So all those threads would come here. This is the runnable state. We will try to compare with this real-time scenario. So this running stage, we will compare this running stage. It's a bike. So in your family there are four members: you, your brother, your mother, and father. All of them are ready to ride a bike, but at a time only one person can ride a bike. That's the scenario. So your four members are here. So each member is a thread. So each thread has some priority. So technically the priority ranges from 1 to 10. 1 is the lowest priority and 10 is the highest priority. And 5 is the normal priority. But suppose your father has the highest priority. If your father has the 10 highest priority, 10, then your father would be given opportunity to ride a bike. If your father completes his ride and he moves to the 10 meter stage, so he don't take the bike for the next few days like that. So then he goes to the 10 meter stage. Then still you three members are eligible for riding your bike. So then next comes the next highest priority thread for the execution. Like that, that thread goes from the runnable to running state. So now we'll see how the state changes from running to non-runnable. If you are riding a bike, due to some situation you got an accident and you were admitted at the hospital, then you were blocked from using the bike for a few months. So that is called block stage. So block stage. Then you move from running to non-runnable stage. Non-runnable means you are eligible but currently not eligible for execution. This is the one scenario. And the second scenario is, if you are riding a bike, the police stops you at some center and he asks some documents for verification. But you don't have documents at that time. So you were blocked for few minutes and you have to wait for few minutes for using that resource. So at that time, some other members can use those resources. So that's called waiting stage. And then timed waiting means a particular time. You are telling that I can wait only for few minutes. After that, I will use that resource. So that is called timed waiting. These are the three basic scenarios where a thread moves from running to non-runnable state. So if thread needs to move from non-runnable to runnable, then these scenarios needs to be satisfied. Sleep that. If your thread is sleeping for a few minutes, that is waiting, then that time needs to be done. And resume, and then notify. So these are the few triggering cases where the thread moves from non-runnable to non-runnable state. Now we will compare this with the technical details. So new, here n number of threads are getting created and all those threads are eligible for running. This running state would be executed by the core. If you are having Intel Core i3 processor, then your processor would have two cores, dual core processor. That's a dual core processor. Each core is a hyper-threading capability. So hyper-threading means it can execute two threads at a time. So you have two dual core processor and hyper-threading, two threads execution at the same time, at that moment. So Intel i3 is a dual core processor, suppose hyper-threading. So one core, two thread execution, so totally four threads can be executed simultaneously. So in our scenario, there are n number of threads. So n number of nearly four threads can be executed simultaneously, and the other remaining threads are in this thread pool. They are waiting, ready to be, ready to get executed. These are the steps that makes the thread to move from running to non-runnable. There are many other scenarios where thread moves from running to non-runnable. We'll talk more about those things in the upcoming videos in a detailed manner. For now, just consider these three scenarios. Thanks for watching this video. At the end of this video, you will see the channel icon here. Please click on it for subscribing channel. If you like this video, smash like button, comment.